This is the Samsung Galaxy S20 Ultra. It is Samsung's latest smartphone, and it's packed with all the latest camera technology. There are four cameras at the back of this Galaxy S20 Ultra, and one of them has a 108-megapixel sensor. There's also a periscope lens on board, and when all these cameras are used in unison, they allow us to take pictures from very far away. That's right, that's 100 times zoom. Here on this channel, we make a lot of travel videos, and a lot of those videos were shot with whatever we've got in our hands at that particular moment. Which is why we value having smartphone cameras that are able to capture great pictures and videos with high dynamic range. And as the cameras on the smartphones keep getting more sophisticated, the line between what we know as the traditional compact camera and the smartphone camera is getting a bit blurry. Which is why we're comparing the king of compact cameras, the Sony RX100 Mark VII, with the Samsung Galaxy S20 Ultra. And we'll be finding out if the legendary 20-megapixel 1-inch camera sensor on the RX100 can still keep up with the S20 Ultra's 108-megapixel sensor. Or could the results be the other way around? We shot these photos with HDR turn on for both the Samsung and the Sony, and all the photos from the S20 Ultra were shot with the 108-megapixel sensor. And because of that, the S20 Ultra has an 88-megapixel advantage over the RX100. But the RX100 has an advantage over the size of the camera sensor. So which one of these cameras are going to capture the most details in their photos? Now let's take a closer look into these two images. In this set of photos, the Sony RX100 produces a marginally sharper image, allowing you to read the names of the train lines on the train schedule. But in this set, it is the S20 Ultra with the sharper image. And in this set, the results are pretty much tied. Although there is no definitive winner in this comparison, I think the 100-megapixel sensor on the Samsung S20 Ultra should be giving the Sony's compact camera department something to think about. Now in terms of picture quality, the Samsung tends to oversaturate their colours, and some people may find these colours a bit artificial, but some may find it eye-catching. The Sony's colours on the other hand appears more muted. The Sony's colours are generally warmer, and it prefers to keep more of the shadows hidden. And during low light situations, the Samsung's night mode software does a better job in giving you clarity, while again the Sony looks much warmer and gives you a more natural look. When shooting macro photography, the Galaxy S20 Ultra can still struggle to focus on close-up subjects, and this is despite having installed the latest software updates. But when you get it to focus correctly, the depth of field that it produces is pretty incredible. And you'd be easily fooled to think that this picture was taken with a more expensive camera. But when we compare these photos side by side with the RX100, you will see that the Samsung really puts in a bit more work into saturating the colours, which may look a bit artificial to some people, but it does a good job in grabbing your attention. Overall, if you take pictures for sharing on your favourite social media platform, I think the S20 Ultra creates pictures that are very attractive, and the image processing software loves to punch up the saturations and highlights, and it does it very well too when shooting food photography. Do share with us what you think of the pictures here in the comment section below. Now as for the Sony, I think some people may prefer the more natural looking colours and the superior depth of field that the RX100 creates. And if you love more depth of field, you may even want to take a look at the brand new Sony ZV-1. Or you could even try the older RX100 Mark V or Mark IV, as they all can shoot up to f1.8. But you'll be sacrificing the 200mm telephoto lens and the microphone jack on the Mark VII. Now speaking of telephoto lens, let's check out the zoom capabilities on these cameras.
Enhance.
Now the Sony RX100 Mark VII can shoot up to 8x optical zoom for both photos and videos, whereas the Galaxy S20 Ultra can shoot up to 100x zoom for photos and 20x zoom for videos. And despite all the huge spec numbers, the zoom from 10x to 100x is actually digital zoom. Here's a picture that we took at 100x zoom. And we all can probably agree that at 100x zoom, the picture quality isn't as impressive as what Samsung wants us to think it is. Now at 30x, if you don't look at it too closely, you might pass it off as a decent photo. Now from 4x to 10x, Samsung uses something they call a hybrid zoom, which is actually a fancier name for digital zoom. And what they do here is that they use the quad camera system to shoot multiple images at 4x magnification. And then they use software to combine these images to recreate an image that has a greater level of detail, sort of like the deep fusion on the iPhone 11. Now when a digital crop is applied to that image as a result of a 10x digital zoom, theoretically, that image should still retain a good amount of information. So let's find out how it compares to the Sony RX100. Now at first glance, it's quite clear that optical zoom still has the upper hand. There's better dynamic range around the trees, and the differences are more apparent when we take a closer look. Here, the foliage looks better defined on the RX100. And even the coconut trees here look sharper. And if you look closely at the S20 Ultra, it's even missing a few windows. Look, if the zoom feature is your main priority, then the Sony RX100 clearly does the superior job. But if you only use the zoom feature every now and then, you'll have the peace of mind to know that as long as you don't stray too far from 10x, the S20 Ultra will produce a decent shot. The Galaxy S20 Ultra can shoot 8K videos at 24 frames per second, and 4K videos up to 60 frames per second, whereas the Sony RX100 can only shoot 4K videos up to 30 frames per second. And they both can shoot slow motion up to 1000 frames. And in this comparison, we're just looking at 4K videos. In terms of video quality, the S20 Ultra performs well during medium light to low light situations. And during low light situations, you can definitely see more clearly than the RX100. But when it's sunny, it overexposes until everything looks very oversaturated. And in a way, their colors are quite similar to the way they handle pictures. The RX100, on the other hand, has a more natural look. And regardless of the lighting situations, it will always faithfully reproduce the colors to match real life. Which is why we think the RX100 Mark VII has the better video quality. But to be a good video camera, you'll also need to have good audio.
Stabilisation test number something.
Oh, we don't know.
Let's
go!
And now let's listen to the audio from the Sony.
Stabilisation test number something.
Oh, we don't know.
Let's go!
Now the Sony RX100 has never been good with audio, but on the Mark 7 you'll get a microphone jack, and with that you can plug in a Saramonic XM1, which will help you drastically improve the audio quality on your RX100. The S20 Ultra, on the other hand, can record impeccable audio without even using an external mic. And when you couple that with its 40 megapixel front-facing camera, it makes the S20 Ultra a really handy vlogging camera that you'll always have constantly around. The Galaxy S20 Ultra has an amazing feature called Supersteady. And when you turn it on, the video will look as if it was shot on a gimbal. The downside to this is that you'll only be able to shoot it in 1080 resolution. However, the Sony also has a similar feature that shoots only in 1080 resolution. And they call theirs the Steadyshot with Intelligent Active.
Alright, very noisy. Super steady test. Ready? Let's go.
The S20 Ultra also has a video stabilization option when shooting 4K, so let's see how that performs to Sony's active stabilization, also on 4K.
This is 4K with active stabilization. Running test, let's go! Hello, internet!
Wow! I'm surprised at how well the 4K stabilized footage from the S20 Ultra performed. It looked almost as good as the Supersteady. There's a little bit of jitter here and there, but it's not very obvious. And it completely trashes the RX100 in terms of video stabilization. I like to think of the S20 Ultra as a really good compact all-rounder, a Swiss Army knife where you can point and shoot and you can expect good results. While I still have my reservations on their video quality, especially during bright sunny situations, you can rest assured that during a pinch, you can rely on the S20 Ultra to get you that good quality picture. As long as you stay within 10x zoom. And it will capture that candid moment with great video stabilization and great audio quality. And as for the RX100, it's getting quite close to its expiration date. And as a result, there are fewer people buying compact cameras each year. But as you can see from our comparison, the size of the sensor and optical zoom still matters. Now, if you're a camera enthusiast, the RX100 does offer a great deal of manual controls over the S20 Ultra. But I can't say that I'm a big fan of navigating through Sony's rather complicated menu. To shoot a slow motion video on the S20 Ultra, it's as easy as tapping on a few buttons on the camera app. But on the RX100, you probably need to read the manual. So, If you're into content creating but you don't want to fuss too much about the settings, you should probably take a look at the S20 Ultra. Samsung typically discounts their phone whenever they launch a new one, so if you wait till they launch the new Note 20 later this year, you could grab the S20 Ultra for a bargain. But for the camera enthusiast that loves to travel light, the RX100 Mark VII will give you the freedom to shoot great photography and great videos without carrying the bulk. We hope you've enjoyed this video, and if you have, please do give us a thumbs up. And please do consider subscribing, as we'll be comparing the 1-inch camera sensor on the RX0 Mark II, and the 1-inch camera sensor on the Insta360 1R. Thank you for watching, we'll see you in the next one. Bye!